Hi, this is Attorney David Gibbs with the National Center for Life and Liberty. We've received many phone calls at our ministry offices at the NCLL asking about a recent Supreme Court decision. It's a positive decision that the Supreme Court ruled in favor of a Catholic school. Many people refer to it as the Lady of Guadalupe case. And the facts in this case were a teacher was challenging an action taken by the school. And the trial judge originally said the school had the right to make these determinations because this teacher was involved in teaching the faith and espousing the doctrines of that church. But the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals said, no, we're going to hold private religious schools to these secular standards. And that's what was appealed up to the United States Supreme Court. In a good ruling, the United States Supreme Court, by a 7-2 vote, proceeded to affirm the school's right to make its hiring and firing and employment decisions based on religious grounds without the government stepping in and imposing secular laws over what the church or the religious organization determined to be best. This is an excellent ruling for faith-based ministries and schools that hire and fire according to their sincerely held religious beliefs. Now, the impact of this ruling is it is critically important for churches, schools, ministry employers to clearly delineate a few things. Number one, all of your employees need to be deemed ministerial employees if they're involved in faith matters, if they have to model or teach or be involved in the religious elements of what you're doing. It's very important that you proceed to make that part of their job description and have that understanding up front. Number two, we would recommend to avoid these kind of lawsuits that you have written employment agreements. This is where the employee up front acknowledges that they're a ministerial employee and that they will be working with your organization on those terms and conditions. We have a sample ministerial employment agreement that is available for download, and it is certainly a template that many ministries may want to use. Included in that agreement is delineating the relationship, the role of the ministry, the role of the faith, as well as resolving all disputes between you and any of your employees with binding Christian arbitration. These are excellent legal protections, and what they do is they minimize risk for you, but very importantly, in wanting to be fair to the employees as well, they lay everything out up front so there's no misunderstandings. Sometimes people will use religious terms and say, well, I thought, or in my opinion. And what the agreement says is that it will be the opinion of the ministry or the church that will determine these things. So very important that churches, schools, others that operate on a faith-based program understand the Supreme Court will defend your right to make these decisions, hiring and firing, based on the faith. But it's important that you spell it out, make it clear, and have it in writing. If you have any questions on these issues or any employment issues in your ministry, our team at the NCLL will defend your rights to hire and fire according to the faith. But we also have coaches and team leaders that will meet with your HR or with your board staff and help them make sure that your employment policies line up with these constitutional protections that are afforded to your ministry.